What's up, fam? Today we are in Phoenix, Arizona, about to go to Whataburger for the very first time. Some say Whataburger is the best burger joint in the United States. So we're gonna go ahead and see what Whataburger is all about. Let's go. Okay, you guys, we got our food. We got a ton of stuff that we are so excited to try out. Lots of drinks as well, which we'll show you in a second. Mm-hmm. But let's go ahead and start taste testing this and see if Whataburger is worth this hype, right, babe?
Yeah, I'm ready. You guys, we also got this Dr. Pepper, by the way. They say this is the best Dr. Pepper in the world, apparently. At least that's what I heard, so.
That's what they say.
So we're gonna sip this in just a little bit, but yeah, let's start taste testing. You guys, we'll explain everything as we eat more and more.
Yes. Okay, I'd say we try with just the regular Whataburger cheeseburger.
Let's do that first. No,
it's up to you.
Let's do that first, yeah. I think that's a
good
idea.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay. We're going standard. We're going for it.
We're going for it, guys.
Oh, it smells really good, actually.
Oh, that does look good.
Okay, I don't know if you guys can see that.
Yeah.
Just looks like your standard burger.
Okay.
Okay, you go first.
Well, before I do it, I want to just show them, too, what's on it. So there's obviously lettuce, tomatoes, pickles, mustard right there.
Okay.
And this is a cheeseburger. What's interesting is they put the cheese, my bad about that.
No worries.
Sorry. They put the cheese on the bottom, so that's kind of different, right?
I agree.
It's a little different.
It is a little different.
Okay. It's a little tough elbow room in here, guys, I'm going to have to go this way.
Okay. You know what?
One more bite.
I wasn't expecting the mustard. I probably should have added mayo.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't mind the mustard. It's actually really good.
Yeah. Usually when I get burgers, I do get mayo on it.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good burger, though.
I don't really miss them. I mean, I could have used it, but
yeah.
I don't need it.
For sure.
It is a good burger.
It is a good burger.
Mm.
For me, I don't need the tomatoes, though. The tomatoes are almost as thick as the burger itself, the patty. So to me, it kind of washes it out a little bit. You know
I can
what I mean?
See that, yeah.
So let's take off the tomatoes, and I want to try one more bite.
Okay, sure.
I know we got a lot of food, guys, but I'm going in.
Okay, uh-oh, they have a pit.
Oh, no, the one I ate had the pit.
Oh, it did.
Yeah, it's all good.
It did have the pit.
So, okay, cool. Let's try it one more time.
Okay.
All right, that way I give it a full bite.
Okay, you're gonna spill all over me. Like, you feel spilling all over me. I feel like wet on my hands.
I'm like eating right over you.
I was gonna say, burger's very good, very solid quality. I have no issue with the burger.
Yeah, I like it a lot, very good.
I have to say, very good. Whataburger is on game with their sauces. Mm-hmm. Look at these sauces, you guys. We got jalapeno ranch, regular ranch.
Mm-hmm. We got a spicy ketchup right there, which I can't wait to try this out. I cannot wait.
Jamil wanted some creamy pepper sauce, so we don't know what that is.
Yeah, but it sounds good.
And then I got some honey barbecue. So
cool.
We should open these too.
I know. Well, so before we do it though, I want to try this Dr. Pepper.
Okay.
You guys, this Dr. Pepper, they say, like I said, is supposedly the best in the world.
Yeah.
At least that's what I heard. So, would you like to try first?
Okay, sure.
You go first.
Let's see.
Even though Kristen's not really a Dr. Pepper drinker much. Really? Let me try.
Solid. That's a solid Dr. Pepper.
This is better.
That's a solid Dr. Pepper.
This is better.
Don't you think so?
How?
It's kind of like McDonald's, like their Coke and their Sprites are like super good. That's how I view like this Whataburger.
Dr. Pepper.
Gosh, brain fart, yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
It's like crispy.
Isn't it?
It's like super crisp. Wow.
It was really, really good.
You guys, this is really good. Yeah. Abnormally good. Usually it's very syrupy and stuff like that, but.
Yes.
But not here. It's like a really good balance. It's like right in between.
Mm-hmm.
Man,
That's quality.
I'll admit that's the best Dr. Pepper I've had. Yeah, it's very good. Okay, what are we going to
just
next?
So you know, we tried to order a Dr. Pepper milkshake. They used to have it, but they don't have it anymore.
Yeah.
But we did get a banana pudding milkshake.
We got that right
which
there.
Which I'm about to try, really
You want
to
try it?
Really good. Okay.
Yeah, we're going for it, huh? Ooh. It's good.
Oh. Yeah, that's a solid milkshake for sure. Mm. I like that they have unique flavors.
You made it easier for me to drink. Kristen had the hard part.
So next we have to try some of their spicy ketchup and some onion rings, okay?
Oh, we gotta go for the onion rings. You guys, I'm not a big fan of onion rings, but a lot of you guys said that we had to try this, so mm-hmm. let's try it out. Okay. See how it is.
I wanna try it without it first.
Oh, you're gonna try it without it?
Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Okay, here these are bomb.
All right.
A lot of people said this. Ooh.
Try them too. Try them out. There you go.
These are.
See how they are.
Man. These are really good. Okay. I dipped it in some spicy ketchup. The spicy ketchup's on point.
Oh, this is really good. Yeah, I heard somebody say on a video that this was a similar to like a ketchup and sriracha type of flavor. Honestly, this is better.
Dude.
I've put spicy sriracha in ketchup, but it just doesn't taste quite as good. That's good. And now the onion rings for me, actually for me, I'm not a big fan of them, but these are probably some of the better ones I've ever had.
Yes, they melt in your mouth.
They melt in your mouth.
I've never had that before.
They're done very well. They're not like super hard and stuff like that. They're not too big, which is another problem. They're perfect.
They really are.
It's really good.
This probably is the best fast food onion ring I've ever had.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
It's good.
Oh, yeah.
Should we try the fries?
Yeah, let's try the fries.
Okay, let's try
it. I'm about to go to town on onion rings.
I know. All right, here we go.
Mmm, that's good.
You know what?
This is a solid fry right there.
If I had to compare this to something...
I know what you're going to say.
I guess it'd be more like McDonald's. It'd be like McDonald's fries. You know, it's interesting, too, looking around, too, at this place, it kind of has, like, a McDonald's vibe with the booths and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
It has a little bit of a McDonald's vibe. It's good, though.
It does.
All right.
Man.
Drink.
Hello, yes, please.
Go right ahead.
I'm happy.
You guys, these fries are very good. I think...
Man.
It's one of the things that makes... Oh, I know, right?
Dr. Pepper is hella good.
Mm-hmm. That's one of the things that makes a fast food place, I feel, are really good fries, right?
Yes.
Because burgers are always going to be good, but fries are hard, I feel, to perfect. You know what I mean?
These taste like McDonald's.
I feel like they are. I do.
Yeah.
They're very good.
Whataburger, been around since 1959. They know what's up.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try another sandwich.
Okay, let's do it.
You pick.
All right. I'm going to do this one.
Okay. It's a
big... Oh. Is that a... No, let's do this one.
Okay.
Let's do the spicy chicken sandwich, you guys. Let's try that out.
We have 1, 2, 3, 4 sandwiches, so.
Cool.
You open it, please.
You want me to open it?
Yes.
Sure. All right.
Thank you, though.
I'll try not to spill any this time.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Oh, okay. You thank you.
You want to show them?
Oh, okay. So this is mayo.
Uh-huh.
So this has lettuce, mayo, tomato, pickles, and the spicy chicken.
I say we take the tomatoes off just because it's hard to taste it with the tomatoes. It is, you guys. I don't like tomatoes.
Conveniently. Here, do you want to grab them?
Yeah. <I'll take>
It's hard to taste it with the tomatoes. Is it hard to taste it with the tomatoes?
It's hard to taste it with the tomatoes.
Oh, God.
Especially since I don't like tomatoes, so it just makes it easier.
Oh, God. I'm going to try it by itself, and then I'm going to open that jalapeno ranch.
Okay. Thank you.
That's different.
This is very different.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
The spicy. It's a unique flavor.
That's the inside.
It is spicy. Like, it definitely has a kick to it.
It's not overly.
Got this jalapeno ranch.
It's not overly spicy. I do have to say the chicken itself is a little dry, but the flavor makes up for it a lot, to be honest, because it is a very good flavor. Is that the spicy ranch? Okay.
That's a really good jalapeno ranch.
Let's try it.
Ooh, that has a kick to it. Oh, yeah. It's just water.
Ooh, that spicy ranch is good.
Isn't it?
Wow. I mean, they really do have really good sauces.
Mm-hmm.
You guys, that's some of the best spiced ranch I think I've ever had. For sure, by far.
Jalapeno ranch.
Wow.
I don't know if I have my mouth on fire from the chicken sandwich or the ranch.
It's a ranch.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, it's got more.
So this is the type of heat you don't mind, right?
Mm-hmm. It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mind when it has a ton of good flavor.
Yeah.
And if it's not if it's like a 5, a 4 or 5,
yeah,
I can handle that.
Yeah, you can.
I hate when it gets to like 6, 7 on heat level.
Then it's too much, huh? That's very good.
That's a really good ranch.
That's a really good ranch.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely up there. Some of my favorite ranch.
And that chicken sandwich was good. Like you said, I agree with you. It is a little dry.
Yeah.
But I like the flavor of that chicken. I do think it's a little different than
me
unique.
Too.
It's hard to describe,
mm-hmm,
but it's a different flavor.
It's very good, though. Very good.
I think so, too.
All okay. Right. What are we doing next?
Do the patty melt.
Okay.
Okay.
Time for patty melt. Now, I've seen a lot of people do this one, and I felt that it was interesting because, here's a good question, you guys. Texas, did they invent Texas toast? I feel like they did.
I would hope Texas did invent Texas toast.
So this is like a staple item, you know what I mean?
Mm.
The Texas toast, patty melt, you know what I mean?
Grilled, I wonder if it came from Texas.
I'm sure it did, right? But I'm gonna say it did anyways.
It's got some white cheese. So it looks like Thousand Island, grilled onions, 2 patties.
Oh, that looks good.
With the Texas toast. This looks good. They asked for a Monterey melt. They didn't have that anymore, so we went with the patty melt.
Cool.
I'm not mad at it.
All right.
Oh, do you want to go first?
No, you first, for sure, this time.
Okay. You go first next.
Okay, all good. I took it from the corner. Okay.
Is that weird?
Well, just get a lot more bread that way, so. But it's not that weird. Wow.
Man. It's
freaking, you know what?
Yeah.
Quinn?
Freaking solid. Everything's solid right
now. It's good. So I've never had a patty melt with white cheese. Or if I have, I don't remember it. Usually I get it with cheddar.
I'm sure we've had it with white cheese. I know I have.
Maybe. Well, what I want to say is it actually tastes better with the white cheese.
It really does. Because
I've had it with cheddar before and I like it, but this tastes way better.
It's really good.
Mmm.
Do you want to open a sauce? Like, I know you got that creamy pepper one.
Let's do it.
You want to try that one? Okay.
Let's try it.
And I'm going to open a ranch.
Creamy pepper. Sorry, guys. Our lighting is not great.
Okay.
We're going to do our best, though.
We're just the regular ranch.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shoot. I'm spilling. I feel like you.
I know.
I pulled a Jamil. Okay.
I'm spilling it everywhere.
You want to try the creamy pepper?
Let's try it
for you, and then let me know if it's good.
Cool. All right. Here we go, guys. Oh, I spilled something again.
I can't complain. I just spilled the ranch.
You knew what you were into when
you
married.
Oh, my God. I know.
There we
okay.
go.
You got it.
Hmm.
If it's not good, I'm going to dip it in ranch.
It's very good.
Okay. You have some leftover, so I'll have this bite.
Mm. But it's not strong. It's not as strong as that ranch, so I can't really taste it. Let me try it with the fry.
It's like...
Let me try it with the fry.
It's weird. That's weird. Sauce.
Hmm.
Try it with ranch regular.
Is that good?
Oh, yeah.
With this pepper sauce, it does taste good. It kind of has a little bit of like a sweet almost taste to it.
Yeah.
But it's very light, so it's hard to. I thought it was gonna be a little stronger because of the pepper.
Mm-hmm.
But it still tastes pretty good.
It's a light pepper flavor, but
yeah,
it's hard to explain.
Mm-hmm.
It's not my favorite sauce. You want to dip it in this ranch and just see if you like it?
Yeah.
Regular ranch.
Let's try it.
Spotty melts on point.
It's very good.
And I love these onion rings. What do you think?
It's good.
Yeah, the jalapeno ranch.
Pretty standard.
The jalapeno ranch is better.
That's where it's at. Mm-hmm. That's really where it's at. The jalapeno ranch is very good. Mm-hmm. Very, very good.
Mm.
So how are you liking this so far?
It's really good.
So far, you loving it?
This is quality.
Mm-hmm. It really is.
Yeah.
Can a couple more fries really quick.
We've also heard, because we are in Phoenix, we've heard that the Texas Whataburger is way better than Arizona's Whataburgers. Mm-hmm. And I actually do agree with that because, well, I don't agree with it because I don't know. But I know what you guys mean because we feel that the In-N-Out in California is better than the In-N-Outs in Nevada. So.
Yeah. It's true.
But we're very happy so far with our Whataburger choices.
Honestly, it's very good. Very good. I'm not complaining at all.
Okay. Okay, you pick next.
Okay, I think we should go for the bacon special.
Okay, we have two more burgers left.
Two more. Now, this one is pretty much, I think, the same burger, right?
But
yeah. It's just with bacon?
Cheeseburger, but with bacon.
Oh, it's a double.
Oh.
Okay, it's a double right there.
I forgot, so I got a double.
I don't know if you guys can see that.
I can do
so
that.
Once again, tomatoes on that, which I think we're going to take off in a second.
We'll take off the tomatoes. Yeah. Take off the tomatoes.
For sure, but it's got some bacon on there. You got the pickles on there. You got the mustard, of course, on there. Let's go for it.
You go first.
Me first?
Yeah,
okay, you thank
first.
You.
Yeah.
All right. This, by the way, this is a big burger. I feel like it's a big burger. I do gotta say, maybe not the freshest of buns, but it still tastes really good.
Mm-hmm.
It looks really good. Here we go.
Also, this booth that we're in, you guys, it's really made for like one person, maybe one and a half. Jamil and I are squeezed in.
Or two very small people.
Exactly. Okay, let's try this. Bacon cheeseburger. Mm.
That's good.
Mm.
Yeah.
I really like it.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Mm-hmm.
So, the thing with the first one versus this one, you really do need, in my opinion, the extra patty, because then you can really taste the meat and really get full flavor going.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like the other one, now that I think about it, that one patty, it was too much bread to meat ratio.
Mm-hmm.
This one's much better.
And that's how Jamil feels about In-N-Out, too.
That's definitely how I feel about In-N-Out. Actually, with In-N-Out, sometimes I'm like, you gotta get four.
Yeah.
You can't just do two. And when I say sometimes, I mean all the time, because that's all I get.
So the jalapeno ranch with this?
Ooh. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
It's good with it?
Mm.
I know, this jalapeno ranch is on point. It's on point.
The jalapeno ranch absolutely hits. Very good.
Mm. Let me try with the ketchup.
Mm.
Try a little bit with this ketchup.
Ah. I'm stuffed.
Mm.
Mm. That spicy ranch is like super good.
Very good.
Super good.
I gotta say, I really like this burger.
Me too.
You know, the bacon itself tastes standard. Tastes like bacon at any other fast food place.
Mm-hmm.
But the burger is quality.
Mm-hmm.
It tastes a lot better than a lot of places we've gone to. Cool.
I think so too. But
mm-hmm.
Is it an In-N-Out burger?
We're going to get to that in just
a few. We'll get to it, yes.
We'll let you guys know in a few
but
how
so
we really feel.
Yeah. But these are solid. Mm-hmm. Okay, we have one more honey barbecue chicken strip sandwich, so we're going to mm-hmm. go ahead and go for that.
Okay.
Hella full right now.
As we eat more fries.
Yeah. The fries are hella good.
They are good.
Very good. Dip it in this honey barbecue sauce.
Okay.
Okay. You can go first.
All right.
But we'll show the fam what it looks like.
Okay.
Mm.
Ooh, so look at that, you guys.
Ooh.
This is.
Ooh.
Let me flip that.
Okay, honey barbecue. Got some chicken strips. Got the white cheese again.
Yep. And then
a couple pieces of cheese.
The honey barbecue smells really sweet, which obviously. Well, sorry. Yeah. Oh yeah, not honey mustard. Honey barbecue. I'm tripping.
Yeah.
I was like, why is it barbecue sauce looking? Anyways, doesn't matter. Smells really sweet.
Mm.
This thing is heavy. They give you a lot. Let's try it out.
Let's try it. Ooh.
Sorry, guys.
We both had a burp.
There we go.
It looks really good.
Mm.
Okay. Ooh. Dripping the barbecue sauce on the back.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
So two things to say. I know what it is. The Texas toast on here is the best Texas toast I for sure ever had at any fast food place, hands down, because it tastes a little more buttery.
Mm-hmm.
It tastes a lot more buttery than some of the other stuff. A lot of times, they don't really put much on it. Sorry about that.
Oh, okay.
But this one's really, really good. However, I'm not a big fan of these type of sandwiches chicken strips with the honey barbecue sauce sandwich. I'd rather use just the chicken strip as a dip. And dip it, you know?
Which some people suggested. Mm-hmm. They like to dip, I think, just the chicken strips in the honey mustard, mm-hmm. which I can see why that's good. I do have to say, this chicken strip is dry. It's mm-hmm. definitely not the best chicken strip at all. Mm-hmm. I don't like that sandwich, I'm not going to lie. That's You're definitely, gonna, no, subpar sandwich, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. I didn't like the chicken strip, and it wasn't juicy. It definitely was pretty dry. Mm-hmm. The honey barbecue is okay. Mm-hmm. It's not bad. Maybe I'll take this off so you can see the chicken strip.
Yes.
Hopefully you guys can see that.
By the way, guys, I want to shout out Nivea.
Sorry.
Mm-hmm. I want to shout out Nivea. I apologize mm-hmm. about that. She's awesome. She's the one that actually helped us in the front. Because this is our first time here, you guys, we're kind of like, what do we get? She helped us out a lot. So mm-hmm. we definitely want to shout her out and say thank you so much for everything.
Thank you, Nivea.
Yes, for
Very
sure.
sweet.
Okay. That is sweet, huh? Okay, let me try that.
No, she's sweet.
She was.
I don't know what you think by itself.
Yeah. It's not for me.
Yeah.
I've never really been a fan. I've never really been a big fan of these chicken strips with this type of sauce. Mm-hmm. A lot of people do love it. It's not for me. Although separately, I like the chicken strips and I like the sauce. Mm-hmm. But it's together, they just don't hit for me. You know?
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
But that's okay. Because mm-hmm. we got like hella burgers that have been super quality.
Exactly. That's right.
Well.
Okay. Is that everything?
That's everything.
Yeah. We finally did it. Since we started our channel 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. 3.5, I think. Something like that. You guys have been saying, you gotta try Whataburger. We've been wanting to go here. We finally got a chance to do it. Mm-hmm. And I really like it. I'm happy. But now I do want to ask you, out of all of the sandwiches that we got,
yeah,
which one was your favorite?
Man.
Actually, yeah, which one was your favorite?
I don't know. I think I liked, I thought the burger was quality. I think I liked just the double burger, or the cheeseburger by itself. But if it was double, it would have been, I think, better. I agree with you. And I liked the patty melt. Okay. So I liked two of them.
Okay.
How about you?
I think for me, it is between the bacon double burger and the patty melt.
Okay.
I think mm-hmm. it's between those two. Uh-huh. But if I had to choose one, like mm-hmm. if I was just going to get one thing, I'm going with that patty melt, I think, every time.
I think me too.
That patty melt, it had so much cheese on there, mm-hmm. and it was the onions taste really good. And like I said, something's up with that Texas toast bread.
Yeah, it's
that
really bread tastes good here.
Very, very good. Uh-huh. So I definitely have to say that. I'm going to say, as far as my favorite item here, it's literally going to be between the fries and the patty melt, in my opinion. I'm still going with the patty melt, but the fries, honestly, I would say if you're going to come here, if you've never been here before, get the patty melt, the fries, and the Dr. Pepper.
Yeah, I agree.
That's what you got to get.
I think I like the onion rings and the fries equally. Fries definitely give that McDonald's vibe. Onion rings, you've never had anything like these before. They're just like melt away.
Exactly.
And then, yeah, patty melt, Dr. Pepper, and you're golden.
Okay. I got one last question for
you. Yeah.
On the count of three.
Yeah.
We're going to say, which place do we like better? In-N-Out or Whataburger? Yes.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Okay, you ready?
Okay.
On the count of three.
One, two, three.